حق بطن غير إن شاء الله.
We are live
now. See? This one is the tough guy. This is actually a movie soundtrack from the 70s, yeah, from the 70s. This is like really cool beat. Soundtrack, and this is
from the movie.
Yeah, it's like a murder mystery.
Oh, right.
I think he was a cop. He played the role of a cop. Isaac
the singer
Hayes.
Himself.
Huh?
The singer himself.
Himself, yeah.
Yeah,
Isaac
okay.
Hayes. Yeah. And the movie was called Tough Guys. We have some good. Some really good beats on this one, huh? That's one and beats, you know, just really good percussion. Amazing soundtracks. And this is the title. Hi there guys, we're doing another one of our crate digging streams. Once again, Hiranya's got some super 12 inches, some albums that he's going to share with us. So, shall we just go through this?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
So, first.
What's that one?
I found this album which is, I think, almost 30 years now, which has been out.
Oh
by
my
Arrested
God,
Development.
Yeah.
I'm sure you pretty know the.
Oh yeah, Arrested Development. This is almost 30 years now, yeah?
Yeah.
1991 or something like that. Yeah, cool tempo.
Yeah.
The album, 3 years, 5 months and 2 days in the life of Arrested Development. This is like a classic album from the very early 90s. But just like last time, Hiranya, this also, this was a good album, like great tracks. But we had to find the 12 inches to like play it out,
yeah.
Because these the album versions on this was great for just like domestic listening, but really had the right audio quality to punch it out in a club. Yeah, so didn't have that. Yeah, for us DJs we needed the. But yeah, nevertheless, what an album this was. Yeah, great album. 30 years almost, guys. 3 years, 5 months, and 2 days in the life of Arrested Development. So what are the
12s? I've got a couple of 12 inches of Arrested Development, so I've got Mr. Wendell.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
Shout out to our good buddy DJ Wendell.
Of course.
So Mr. Wendell, remember this Mr. Wendell? We've got the old BPMs written, 110 beats per minute.
So Tareeq, why do you have the same track on separate records, like, you know? Is it the is it the same mix? Yeah, right?
Yes.
It's the same song, right?
My daughter is also... it's the same song actually, Hiranya. Now this was the promo that came out first. So this one... let me see, can't even remember. So Yeah, so this has about five versions of Mr. Wendell.
Alright.
Yeah, so it's got the album version, a radio edit, and some other four DJs only, it says here, for DJs
for
only.
DJs only.
Yeah,
right.
So this was, let's play this. This is like some really cool beats that came on the B side here.
Wow.
This is not actually an instrumental only, but it's just more beats, you know?
Right. So you could get creative.
You can get very creative on this. You can take this and sample it over something else,
right.
You know?
Percussion.
Yeah, the percussion on this, you know?
That's nice.
Really, really cool beats here.
Wow.
Got that whole African thing going on, you know? Then,
is a chair. He gives me some knowledge, I buy some shoes.
So that's on this particular version, this particular record, it's got five different versions of Mr. Wendell. But then this was the commercial release, I think. It came out a little bit, you know, the promo is always comes out before. So this has Revolution on it. It's also got the full length version of Mr. Wendell.
Oh, right.
And the label's also different. So this is out on Chrysales, and this is Cool Tempo. So it's
two different
labels, you know. But I think all on BMG. I think they're all BMG. Yeah.
Okay.
So yeah, that's why I have a different, because you get them in different. So as the album comes out, we, you know, start looking for the promos for that is out on 12-inch. So usually the promos are out first, and then this is, you know, the commercial release.
Right.
Yeah, so that's how it goes.
So when speaking of Arrested Development, you can't forget the track called People Every Day, right?
Oh my God, yeah.
I'm sure everyone knows that song, yeah?
Everyone knows this one.
So why do you have three records on it, the same song?
Same song,
what's
three records.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm not sure myself now. Oh yeah, so basically here again, these two are what I would use for, I think, yep, these on Cool Tempo, and it's also on
Cool Tempo.
So you know, we didn't have all the gadgets on the mixers back then, so we needed to use two records on either side if we wanted a instant doubles kind of getting different effects, like the phasing, flangers, all
so
those
it was
things.
All done through just records.
Just through
two records,
you know, a little bit of reverb, just one playing behind the other, you know,
I see. Yeah.
That kind of thing. So that's why, and you always needed two copies of the identical record, and identical copies. So as, and this is the promo,
this
came out first,
right.
I would say, yes.
Oh, right, that's a white label.
Yeah, this is the Chrysalis, this came out before this. So this is what we get first. Yeah, I've got the BPMs written there, you know.
Yeah,
man. Brings back so many memories. But yeah, so that's the reason of a lot of my records, I think I have doubles for that reason,
I see.
Be careful. My daughter is also here today. we've got some people
questions.
Joining us, I think. Hi there, Angelo. So yeah, that's some of my DJ friends are like, hey man, you got 2-3 copies, why don't you send us all, you know? What do I do after that? No, it's really cool to play around with doubles. I mean, you know, you've been doing that, so
that's
about story
it.
With Arrested
Development. The nice family, this 12-inch.
Oh, this one too.
Tennessee.
Tennessee, man. My gosh. Shall we play this, man?
Sure.
Remember? Whoa.
Is there anything special about this album? I mean, the record?
Oh, yeah. See, this has Tennessee Back to the Roots remix.
Oh,
this
right.
This came on the... Oh, now I remember. So this was on the flip side. And I think that's the remix that's like really...
All right.
The album version is,
it's...
You know? Yeah. Yeah, it's the straight original album version, but then the Back to the Roots remix, which is on the B side, second one. So I mean, this is Tennessee. Got the real punch on that one, yeah. That's really, really.
One, two.
Here we go.
So as we can see here, guys, I mean, these on reverse, so it's got four versions, and on the B side you've got this Back to the Roots remix of Tennessee, which is like really, really good. See that one now? Why does it have to be so damn tough? Why does it have to be so damn tough? I don't know where I can trust the living. Yeah, Tennessee. Really, really good stuff.
And I got actually three from the same song. Ease My Mind.
Okay.
What's that one?
Yeah. But I think Ease My Mind was this again. I have three copies.
Yeah.
Dude. But this was not from that album.
That's the we spoke about. All
yeah. This album came out around 91, 92.
Okay.
Yeah, it's almost 30 years. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
But this was a release that came out a little later on as a single, I think, somewhere in 96, 7, I can't even remember now, I think. Ease My Mind was a little later.
Oh, right.
Yeah, for 94 or 5. So here again, yeah, see the different pressing standards. This is on Chrysalis, and these are all Cool Tempo, okay?
Yes.
Cool Tempo Red labels. These also had like red label, blue label, black label.
Right.
Yeah. See that if you look at this, see these are the Cool Tempo black labels.
Black labels.
You got the red label.
Red
But yeah.
So they had blue labels as well?
Yeah, there was no, there was no blue label. They didn't go up to that quality standard, yeah.
Right.
But yeah, so these Ease My Mind. It was 1990. Hey, baby, now hold on, we're doing a video here. this was 1994. Yeah, so it was after that album.
After that.
Yeah. So here again, why, you know, we always hold on to a few copies, because it's mainly for beat juggling and, you know, instant doubles kind of thing. And also because of the pressing. So I always like to have the promo as well as, you know, your Cool Tempo Red label. So that's... yeah, but this is a super fine band. I mean, this album is, it's worth quite a bit. These are first pressings, so they are quite rare now to get, you know, a good album. Yeah, Hiranya's going through all the records and
so,
just
yeah.
finding some.
Found another double, Rice by Herb Alpert.
Oh, what's that? What? Oh, yeah, man. Herb Alpert, Rice. So this is the sample that... Notorious B.I.G. used, I think, for Hypnotize.
Hypnotize. Oh, yeah. Right.
Yeah, this is the one, I think. Yeah.
I think we should...
Let's try and play this one out a little. If we don't get muted, man.
That's one thing.
Yeah. So, these came out on 45 or 33 RPM stereo. Yeah. Oh, hey there. Hi, folks. We got Candy and Vindika.
Angelo
and Aman Ashraf, an old friend.
Yeah
so we're just looking through some of the now. So yeah, these are instant doubles. You can actually play it on that side. And so
yeah.
what we would do is, see. So when you, like, when you come to that part, which is this, but this is how we used to do instant double back then, you know? Now it's just, you know, you can press a button here and it becomes instant. And then. But that's why we actually have a lot of these same record, you know,
right,
getting doubles. This is the real reason, actually. Yeah. But these are super fine, yeah. What else you got, man?
So,
Herb
got,
wow.
So, I'm sure everyone knows a track called Be Faithful by Fat Pen Scoop, right? So,
oh yeah, yeah. Big 90s tune, is
yeah,
it? Or
yeah,
2000s?
Late 2000s.
Okay. So oh, that one
that,
here, no?
That one. This one.
Oh,
and then
Be Faithful.
I think Love Like This by Faith Evans.
Yeah, that's
but
right.
I think I found the original track of it, like how the sample, the original sample.
Okay.
By Chick.
Oh, Chick. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Chick Shea.
So I'm sure you.
Yeah, yeah. This is the Bernard Edwards remix.
Oh, right.
Yeah,
yeah,
it came out around 1984. This one, case the yeah the 84 remix. See?
I'm sure people will recognize as soon as
yeah.
You know,
shall we play
yeah,
this?
Yeah, sure.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay. Yeah, folks. So this is Chick Shea. This is Bernard Edwards remix. It was a 45, I think. See. Okay,
yeah.
Ready. Yeah. Okay, so that's the Be Faithful.
Be Faithful.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah, 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 yeah. That one, Fat Man Scoop.
So we played every night, every weekend.
Oh, this is still played out
yeah,
a lot.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You mean this one or that?
This one.
This one, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sometimes Faith Evans was on.
Oh, okay, okay.
Love the track. I mean, people, the Chick
yeah.
had put out a lot of samples.
Oh
right?
Yeah,
and
actually you're right. We should, I mean, that's true. We should do a separate little episode and just all the Chick,
yeah,
get
Chick's,
all of the Chick songs
yeah.
out and, you know, there are lots and lots of, and those samples we used in many,
many
tracks, yeah. Oh yeah, man, this is a good
song from 80s, is it?
Yeah, very, yeah, 80s, 1984 this was. As in, this is actually the 84 remix, but the original was somewhere around 82, I think. So, Bernard Edwards, this was actually Nile Rodgers and Bernard Edwards. So, Nile Rodgers would do all the guitar work.
Oh, right.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Good, good album, man. This is like superstar. Yeah.
And of course, after that.
On Atlantic.
Rapper's Delight.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That also, even on this track, they used the. I think the backing track was Good Times by Chick.
Oh, Chick.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah,
yeah,
yeah,
yeah. On this,
yeah.
on Rapper's
Delight. Yes, yes, yeah, true.
You know?
So I found this other.
What's this? Okay, right, Xanadu and Sweet Lady.
Sweet Lady, yes.
My God, these guys were like full-on one-hit wonders.
Oh.
Yeah. They did a similar, like a female version of Rappers.
Like, listen to it?
Yeah, sure, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, this one. I played. Yeah. My God, yeah, this is like a really old record. But these guys were doing a lot of like reggae stuff also.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And you don't stop. Rock it to the bang bang boogie. Say up jump the boogie to the rhythm of the boogie the beat. Now what you hear is not.
So Rapper's Delight, same thing. Yeah.
But the,
just that
the females
vocal. Yeah. They're called Xanadu and Sweet Lady. But they did a lot of reggae stuff.
Oh.
Yeah, there's a lot of reggae stuff by Sweet Lady.
You don't stop, rock the ring that make your body rock. Well, so far you heard my voice.
See the lyrics, everything are the same.
The same
play,
huh?
That. Yeah, it's the same thing, man. Some 45.
You don't stop the rocket to the bang bang. Make say up, jump the
bang
to the
rhythm.
Yeah, it's a female cover.
That's one, and I'm tons of fun. And I
stop the rocket to the beat. And me,
and Jeff Kelly, and address.
You gotta try to move your feet. See, I am Wonder Mike, and I love to say hello.
So that's actually the oldest version of Rapper's Delight. By Xanadu and Sweet Lady. Superb find, man. You can play these out, maybe.
Yeah, we have to try and see.
Yeah.
Younger generation male.
Of course, yeah. They'll, you know.
And I
superb.
Keep, you know, finding doubles. So I
I was famous to try and find as many copies of the same album.
Ah, really?
Yeah. I was always looking for more copies.
So you to me are everything.
Hey, give us a minute. We are on live on Facebook.
So the same track, you have doubles. So
what's
that's
this one?
This is you to me.
The real thing.
Real thing.
Yeah. Okay. So this one is the white label that came out.
That's a white label.
This is on promo.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So you.
So this is
you
always,
get it first, yeah.
Yeah, the promos
always
come out first. You know.
Right.
And this particular promo is this is the side that has songs. Now you play this side. You got nothing there, man.
Just empty.
It's empty. Folks, so this is a typical single-sided promo, what we call a single-sided promo. There's nothing on the B-side.
Just dead backs.
It's dead backs, yeah. So you can actually cut something. We can put it on a cutter. put something on there. So this is, this is the 12-inch. It's also got the a cappella, that famous, you know.
Oh, baby!
That's the a cappella, no?
Yes, I need to be.
It's not the a cappella, this actually starts like this.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
The 12-inch, the extended, this is the special club mix.
Club mix.
You know? The a cappellas are somewhere here.
I'd do anything for you, your wish is my command.
And you can, that was what was cool about these white labels, because you had all the a cappellas, they had the instrumentals,
so.
You know? And, so this is actually
this track is one of my favorites too. Like,
oh really?
Yeah.
A lot of people like a lot of girls like this track too. I've noticed here. Yeah. I mean, back in the day, I don't know how it is now, but used to play this so much. And
so what's so special about this one?
So now you this also has You to Me Everything, but these.
It says 12.
Yeah, this is a series that came out. See, it says a series of 12-inch singles featuring extended mixes. So. 12-inch gold was actually this label called Old Gold. We should do a separate episode on
so
just
sure
all
you
the,
have so many records.
There are lots of old golds. You saw them, na?
Oh, yeah.
And because from everything, from like Earth, Wind & Fire, Herbie Hancock, Howard Jones, Quincy Jones, Evelyn King, all of these, artists, Alicia Bridges, you know, Grandmaster Flash, Furious Fire, SOS Band, all of them.
Came
out on this.
Yeah, right.
They didn't, as in this was, see, a lot of people couldn't find the original 12-inch,
oh,
you know.
Okay.
or the promo. I mean, you miss out on it, you know, sometimes because there's limited copies.
Yeah.
But then these guys, what they did, they reissued it under this label. Yeah. So reissues were, you know, the 12-inch Gold was very famous for reissues of like really solid disco
among
tracks.
DJs.
Yeah, amongst DJs. DJs. Yeah, it's always the extended version or, you know, the 12-inch version, which is very handy for DJs. So, but yeah, and this one has Can You Feel the Force, which is also a big track by The Real Thing.
Real Thing.
Yeah, on the B-side. So they always had like two or three good songs coming out on. So we'll do actually, good you found this.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
We could do another separate video on
that's
the
right,
series,
man.
Yeah?
Just do that. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So, see, guys, so this is also a label. It's called 12-inch Gold. We can do a, excuse me, a separate series on this one. They've got lots and lots of 12-inches on this. You may have, those of you who are DJs, who've probably seen this label also. Very,
yeah.
Very, very famous. Yeah. Very big here in Sri Lanka, but I remember a lot of clubs used to have these. Yeah, man. Superb. So... anything, I saw a little 7-inch
there. Ah, yes.
What was that?
If I Rule the World.
Oh, you found this too?
Yes.
My God.
Is it the original?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I think Nas did a 90s version of it,
Version of it, yeah.
If I Rule the World.
We should,
that.
I think, give
yeah,
it a listen,
give it a
yeah?
spin on that. My God, yeah. This is what Nas did in around the mid-90s. So the original by Curtis Blow. Let the whole world know that the king was in town. As I ride the crowd, start to cheer, and then soon yell out, the king is here! So I head to a stage to make a speech about the new style living out. Yeah, and it has a nice start, man. You see the start of it. You can. So this is Curtis Blow. If I Rule the World. Yeah.
Actually, mix no.
Yeah, it's really nice to you. You know.
If
I
Rule the World.
And there's a 12-inch here, which has the a cappella of this.
Oh, right.
Yeah, the 12-inch is also there.
Yeah,
this is like a really, it's got that hip-hop kind of disco vibe also. Curtis Blow had that other track, I think The Breaks.
The Breaks.
Yeah, that's also there on 12-inch. It's a clap your hands, everybody.
Brody.
That one, yeah. That's also Curtis Blow. And so why is it gotta be so damn tough? That track is called Tough. They're all there on 12-inches. Curtis Blow. Is that it today, or
I
have
think,
you got anything else?
That's it for today, I guess, Tareeq.
Ah,
yeah.
Okay. All right, so. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. This will be on live for the future also, hopefully. And please give us your comments, anything else you'd like to hear. We can
We can do future videos on anything.
Future videos on something else, yeah. So big thanks to Hiranya, who's like coming up with all the tunes and finding all these so we can talk about it.
I'm very excited about it. Like, you know,
yeah, it's
I get to hear a lot of stuff.
Yeah,
I never having to play, like, you know.
Yeah.
It's a gold. I don't know how to explain it though, but I'm very excited about it.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
See, I also just love to, you know, see that we've got another whole heap in that other room down there.
No.
So we'll bring those out and just go through everything, you know. Yeah. Okay, darling, man. Go onto that side and wave to everybody before we say bye. Okay, guys, then. That's
yeah,
it then.
To wrap things up, yeah.
Thank you for watching and hopefully
see you next time.
See you next time.
Yeah. New video.